That's my upcoming book. As you know, from my last book onwards, I switched from I did 7 love stories. I have, if it's a half girlfriend, I can go deep into the Hindi-English divide in India. If you go to YouTube and do deleted scenes of 2 states, there's some fantastic scenes he's shot. I can see why they didn't make it in the final cut. Jo reading ka maza hai. Because it is using your brain ka projector. More and more people have Amazon Prime and Netflix in their homes in India. Then I'll make my books into it.
Chetan, welcome back on Bollywood Hungama.
Nice to be talking to you again, Faridoon. Been a long time.
It has been a long time. All right. And I believe you have been in Singapore for some time.
Yeah, you know, just when the lockdown was announced, I was here. My kids are studying here. And I just happened to be here. And then they announced the lockdown. And since then, you know, since flights are very difficult, and also my family's here, I thought, okay, let me just be here and sit here and write what else to do. Wait for Corona to get over.
Hopefully. All right. What is your guess? When do you think the vaccine will be there in India?
I think I'm very optimistic in a way, because I think I've been not only guessing, I've been watching the pharma company, big pharma companies' trials very closely. Many, many trials are going on, but I think 4 or 5 trials from big companies are in what they call phase 3, which is the final phase, which is basically they give it to 30,000 people and different age groups. It's a very big trial sort of to see for side effects. The vaccine is there. It is working. But now they've given it to 30,000 people to see of any very bad effects or, you know, the mass level, what happens. And I think they will finish the trial and have the vaccine by October, phase 3 trial done. If 5 vaccines are being tried, then 50% chance is there ki each vaccine will work normally. So out of the 5, 1 should work. But I think by the time you have it in your arm, that will be February next year, because it takes a while to, you know, make it, ship it, all the political and geographic agreements have to be there. And then, so I think the whole world will have it by February, which is 6 more months. Corona won't go away, but we will have a vaccine in your arm by 6 months if you want to have the vaccine.
Hopefully. One arranged murder while we deal with Corona. So tell us something about it.
Yeah, so that's my upcoming book. As you know, from my last book onwards, I switched from, I did 7 love stories throughout my career. And then I moved to a love story plus murder mystery genre, because I felt like that's more interesting. That keeps the youth more engaged. Somewhere down the line, there is a move towards that. If you see a lot of web series also, a lot of them are thrillers and, you know, those kind of space. But it's a Chetan Bhagat book, so it will have romance, it will have comedy, but it'll also have a crime that is being solved, because I think youngsters today are less about, I mean, if you give them a book and it's about, does the boy get the girl, they are less interesting to them, did the boy kill the girl? It's just more interesting. So I moved to that genre, and we had done this book. It was coming out in April, May. And we were all ready to announce it. And then, of course, the great Corona stopped everything. So now, again, it's not like Corona is gone. But me and my publisher, we felt, kya kare, himmat dikhaye ki na dikhaye? Because there is nothing. Nobody is releasing anything, right? There are no movies. Yeah. There's no cricket. So in a way, we were scared also. But I also felt, and my publisher also felt, that this is the best opportunity also. Because there is nothing else over there. So right now, we are the only ones. What you need in releasing in a pandemic is a lot of like a digital presence. And I think luckily for me, I've been building that, like by social media, has been quite active for a long time. I'm very comfortable with making videos or technology and things like that. And even Amazon.com and Flipkart are both very big sales point for my books. So even though the bookstores are not fully there yet, online sales is where a lot of Chetan Bhagat readers buy their books anyway. Social media is how I publicize my books anyway. And so we thought, okay, let's go for it. So we went for it. We made a trailer for it, because again, that can be digitally transmitted. And we've got a very good response. And we are very happy we're doing it, because I think I'm getting more response than the last book, because people just have more time and there is not that much content out there.
Okay. Now, you've always been very high on marketing. Over the years, how have you've dealt with many criticism, but how have you dealt with this criticism ki ek kitab ke liye aap You're coming up with a promo. You've done a lot of other stuff in the past as well. You've always been very innovative with marketing, obviously, with this IIM background, and I'm sure that comes in handy. How have you dealt with these sort of criticisms? This is the best book in the world, and the way aise to koi promote nahi karta kitab ko promote karne ka to ye tareeqa hi nahi hai. So how have you dealt with this specific criticism over the years?
Well, I love my books. I mean, I think we should all be very proud of our work. And I know it's a very good book because we've tested it. With at least 50 people, we tested and we got extraordinary ratings. Only then we are releasing it. We never release a book otherwise. So the book is good. The first step of marketing is that whatever your main thing is, whether your content is or has to be really good. So that is good. And I've never been shy of marketing. There is so much content out there. Even a multi-billion-dollar company like Netflix has to do marketing. So who is Chetan Bhagat that thinks that without marketing ho jayega? And who are these purists who feel ki, you know, a kitab hai, a book should be there should be some purity and marketing makes it impure. They are the most stupid literature hating people in this world because they will destroy the publishing industry. They almost have by saying ye mat karo, wo mat karo, wo mat. You know, we have to find innovative ways, and a writer's job is to understand what the society is. And all the youngsters who read my books are on video. This interview is happening on video. They are watching this interview on video. They're on Instagram. They're on YouTube. They are obsessed with video almost. So if I have to remind them, bhaiyo aur behno, ek kitab bhi cheez hoti hai, aap padhiye please. I have to show them a video. I show them a video. I get them to a hook point. It literally, video starts. There's a girl who keeps Karwa Chauth and is found dead on the roof. It's enough for people to have the curiosity. If you want to know what happened, why this happened, who did it, read the book. So it's a way to make youngsters pick up a book. Do you want me to not do it? Do you want nobody to do it? Nobody should tell anybody that a book came out. And how do you plan to make sure it reaches people then? While all the other web series, the smallest of web series is promoting or Till Kingdom Come. So let me also do it. I'm still like bound right now. I can't do much marketing. I can't do a physical book launch. I can't even come and meet you. You used to come home so many times for an interview. You have to do this little window thing. So it's very limited, you know. But itna to karna chahiye na. Like the book should also, we need to tell people we are there. And doing new things, ki aisa hota nahi hai. That's what I've always been about. I've always been about doing innovative things. Some Indians should try innovation, no? Not every Indian should follow in line.
You know, Chetan, something that I've always liked about you, I've known you since a very long time.
Since the 3 years, when you... I mean, I don't know, okay, like... We are old, basically, Faridoon. That's what you're trying to say.
We are very, at least I'm very young. I feel very young. And I think you are very young.
Young also.
You know, so one thing that I've liked about your communication, especially on social media, is that even though people tend to be brutal at times with you, many a times, but even when you reply to them, you are very civil. You maintain that level of decency. Why is it so important for you?
Because, you know, I have a voice which is not just popular, but also credible. When I say something, a lot of people listen and they take it a little bit seriously. I'm not like somebody who's just a popular celebrity, bol diya aur ulti-pulti baat kar di. Agar bola hai, to kuch soch ke bola hoga. So I think the moment you start, which means you can't react emotionally all the time. Mostly, you build more credibility and more strength if you are measured in your responses. It doesn't mean you are boring. I will not be boring. Ki matlab bilkul hi chup rehna hai. Main jawab dunga, lekin badtameezi nahi karunga. Kyunki agar aap badtameezi kar rahe hain, that means aapke paas argument nahi hai. Aapke paas logic nahi hai. Wohi log zyadatar badtameezi karte hain internet pe, jinke paas reasoning ki ability nahi hai. Jo hamara education system mein problem bhi hai. To kai baar wo mere ko lagta hai, ye dekho, ye saboot, Indian education system ka ek aur saboot aaya. Ki padha likha hai, lekin kaise baat kar raha hai. So I think if you have a point to make, you don't have to make it rudely. You will be more effective. Look at any effective leader. They are never rude. I mean, look at the top leaders of anywhere in the world, even in India, they are never rude. They are very gentle and very calm.
Now, coming back to, and I think we met before 3 Idiots. We met for one night at a call center.
Yeah, hello.
I think that came before that. That came before.
2008, that movie came, man.
Yeah. So we met then. Okay, at your
12 years
Kolaba
Yeah, Mantrale mein, 12 years before Corona. There will be like BC again, but BC will stand for before Corona.
Okay, now Vikrant Massey is doing the narration part of it. I think fantastic actor. He was there in Half Girlfriend as well. So why do you think of Vikrant for being the narrator?
Well, you know, sometimes it's just friendships. And of course, he's a fabulous actor. But the main thing is our friendship started during Half Girlfriend. He played the role of Arjun Kapoor's best friend in Half Girlfriend. And he was, of course, I was also there on the sets a lot. And I really liked him. He's the typical Chetan Bhagat character, you know, in a way. He's very Indian, but yet you can tell he's aspirational. He looks real, but there is still something about him that has a spark in his eyes. So I think people will look up to him, but yet he can fit in a Chetan Bhagat book. Some of the, you know, there's just some people who can make very good Chetan Bhagat characters. Like even Sushant, for example, in Kai Puche was like that. That typical Indian middle-class boy who has a dream and wants to do big. So I think I found that in Vikrant. So when I was writing my first thriller, it was the character was Keshav, who's basically a detective, but not a professional one. He teaches IIT coaching classes. And wo lagta hai thoda Vikrant Massey, you know, like he looks like somebody who has studied and a good student, but yet he looks like somebody who can run and fight and things like that also. So I felt that he'll be perfectly cast for that. There have been no movie like trailers for a book. We checked. Even in the world, we couldn't find a trailer like this with dialogues, with like people with voice and with, you know, people don't show the content of the book. They'll, even if they make a trailer, they'll make some concept trailer, like some, you know, stock images, and they will not show characters and all. And I said, I want to make a movie style trailer. So that's how I spoke to Mohit Suri last time, and he was making Half Girlfriend. He said, okay, chalo, banate hain, we'll do it. And let's cast Vikrant in it. And I said, yeah, he's perfect.
So Mohit has directed this. Mohit has directed this.
The first one. Girl in Room 105. This one, Mohit didn't direct it. This one is directed by somebody who was an assistant director in Half Girlfriend and a creative director of Malang, who works with Mohit a lot, Sankalp Sadana. And he's a very young, bright boy who is very passionate. And he said, I'll make it. You know, it's very hard to make a book trailer. People straight away compare it to a movie trailer. But there are two key differences. One is a movie trailer, you have a movie. You have a two-hour movie. Usme se aapko 1 minute kaatna hai. That is the trailer. But in a book trailer, there is nothing to cut. You have to create the trailer. Literally, you have to host and create the trailer. So that is a big challenge. And the second is the budgets. Like a movie is made in a huge budget. This is a tiny, tiny budget trailer. And if you want to add a third challenge, add Corona in it. So we are releasing the, how do you shoot and how do you edit and all that. So ye sab kiya usne, Sankalp did a great job. I helped him with the scripting. And of course, I was supervising everything and the concept of it all. So we just feel like it just creates excitement for a book, which is very hard to create excitement for otherwise these days.
Okay, now there are talks that Arranged Murder is an extension of Girl in Room 105. Is it true?
It's not a sequel. It is not a sequel. But the two characters, the two main detectives are the same. Keshav and Saurabh. You can say it's a bit like Sherlock Holmes, you know? Yeah, like you have different Sherlock Holmes, but they are different stories. So you can watch any episode of Sherlock Holmes, but it doesn't have to mean that you have to see the previous one. But there is some continuity, like the two characters are the same. So you can say it's like a series, maybe, in that category of Keshav and Saurabh, but it's not the sequel, because in the sense, it's you don't have to have read the previous book to read this.
Okay, so several books of yours have been turned into movies, but I think a few of the books are piling up, but the movies are not coming out yet. Announcements
yeah, because, well. yes, because I became very busy with writing. I did a writing contract with Amazon Publishing. Now they are Westland basically in India, and I had to deliver certain books to them. And whenever I have never done a 3-book contract with anyone, and I didn't realize that I take the pressure. You know, if someone gives me a contract that you have to finish this, then until that is done, I can't focus on other things because I'll be very tense. One is that. And the second is the rise of digital platforms, streaming platforms. And I have been a believer in them from a long time. And I feel like it's better to come on that platform than even Bollywood now, I feel, for someone like me, someone like my books, where the story is the star. Because getting a movie actor to cast for a movie takes a long time. We have to wait a lot. So I thought our digital platforms are better. However, their penetration is still low in India. So I thought, let every year they're growing very fast, 50%, 100%. So I thought, let me finish the books. I'll have the content, and all these streaming platforms will be hungry for content. They have to make new things every year. Where are they going to go? They're going to come for the content. Let me wait till more and more people have Amazon Prime and Netflix in their homes in India. Then I'll make my books into those.
So you feel that, okay, you would want to come up with a web series. Okay. Now, and do you feel that several movies have come up on your books? Some have come out nicely. And when I saw Half Girlfriend, so I read the novel a day before that. Before actually going to watch the movie, I was in Shimla. When I saw the film, so I felt they changed the screenplay, the way the book goes, the way it starts and the way it pans out. And the screenplay of the movie was different, completely different. So, you know, I felt a bit let down. That I felt that the sort of excitement that I had while reading the book, and I've always been a fan of your writing and your books, I could not really find that in the movie. The music was outstanding, but somehow I felt a bit let down. So did you get that feedback as well for Half Girlfriend?
Some people did say that, and some people liked it, some people didn't like it. And you know, when I let go, once I select a team, I think it's fair that once you've chosen a team, you let them run with it and not control it. So therefore, sometimes it works out really well. Sometimes it may work out not so well. I mean, to be fair, a lot of people liked Half Girlfriend also. To be fair, a lot of people, some people said things like what you are saying also. So and everybody has a right to the opinion, and there will be opinions. Now, with web series, that's one of the reasons, is that I don't have that constraint anymore of like, you know, trying to fit it into a Bollywood format. I can say that you have to be really loyal to the book. I am also becoming more confident of my content. I used to say that, okay, fine, change it if you have to. But I now know that people love my books, and I know that people love the story. And if it is just told as it's given in the book, but like, of course, make it punchier and make it like a cinema friendly, but not deviate from that plot, it's going to do the job.
Yeah,
so
because
I think I will.
Because, you know, I
agree with you.
You write your novels in a, you know, it's like a screenplay. When you write your novels, you just, the way the entire setting, the way you do it, it is almost like a screenplay. Even for Kai Poche, I think I told you that people who have read the book, in the level of excitement that you feel towards the climax, when the entire, you know, that hullabaloo is going on, that it's like edge of the seat while you're reading it. It's not easy to for anyone to maybe.
It's not easy. See, some of it is inevitable, Faridoon. No matter what I do, no matter how much they stick to the book, in the real world there are budgets. In the real world there are real human beings acting. In the real world there are time limitations of how much shooting you can do, how many takes you can do, what the vision is, and it's very hard to match or beat the reader's imagination. I mean, your imagination, a reader's imagination is, it can be anything, right? And it cannot be met by a director fully. Having said that, you can come pretty close. You can come 80%, 90%. There have been movies, not just mine, there have been other adaptations worldwide where, you know, you've had excellent movies, like A Godfather is an excellent movie of an excellent book. So it can be possible, but largely I'm telling you, if you are a reader, which I know you are, you read a lot of books, you enjoy books, you will never get that feeling in a movie, or you may get it very rarely. That is why I tell even your viewers who are watching this interview, guys, I love video, I love social media, I love movies, but jo reading ka maza hai, because it is using your brain ka projector, it is using your brain ka set design, it's using your brain ka imagination. Unlimited budget. You can imagine 100 helicopters in your head right now. I just have to say, 100 helicopters were in a sunny day on the border. 100 helicopters took off one by one. Boom, you imagined it. Ab ise create karke dikhao. Aapki nani yaad aa jayegi aur crore rupaye lag jayenge. So that is just an extreme example. But what I'm trying to say is, when you read a book, an author has no time limit. You read, take 6-7 hours. You understand the world really well. If it's a Half Girlfriend, I can go deep into the Hindi-English divide in India, whereas a movie can only go so much. So that makes a much more enriching experience. I can go deep into describing Bihar and the funny things about Bihar or whatever. Everything movie may not capture. And you can imagine how this boy felt when Riya's, I don't know, fingers touched his hand. And then, you know, that imagination and that feeling is, immediately you feel that. If I tell you he loved this girl for 5 years and one day she just put her hand on his, you emotionally feel something. How do I show that to you visually? It will not have the same effect. So books rock, guys. Please read books, including mine, but others also. Reading band mat karo. It's a beautiful way to consume stories. And they have lasted the TV, they have lasted movies. So they will last this data 4G generation also and 5G also. You should give them a chance.
One of the movies, so we'll come to 3 years later, but one of the films which I felt did justice to quite an extent was Two States. I felt that it was a good film in terms of the way. I love Kai Poche. I really love Kai Poche, but they change a lot. I think from the original book, as a film, it works nicely. Like Two States is something, obviously, even the book, there's so much more in terms of back and forth and the entire Punjabi element.
Humor.
And, humor.
People find Two States a funny movie, but if you read the book, it's 10 times funnier.
It's very, the mother-son, I think, conversations, I think they're hilarious and they just keep going on and on. But still, I felt they handle it quite nicely in terms of, you know, it gets you that goosebumps by the end of it. You do feel certain, that danger moves
on. Yes. And I think he was a debut director, you know, probably. Abhishek Varman, you probably know him.
Yes.
He was a debut. He was a big fan of the book. He was truly a big fan of the book. And he was a debut director.
I think that.
So
I
he
think
said,
it's
you know what?
Too.
Yeah, he said, I love the book. That's why I'm making it. I don't need to change it. I'm a new director. I want to be safe. If the book has worked, I will do it. And he made it. In fact, you know, he has shot some scenes which are in the book which didn't make it to the movie. If you go to YouTube and do deleted scenes of Two States, there's some fantastic scenes he's shot. I can see why they didn't make it in the final cut, but he's done it really well. Like, you know, so they just didn't make it. So he actually shot the book and then he compiled a movie out of it. So that also worked. Yeah, I agree with you. I think why, if I am taking a bestseller, right? I am paying for it. I am telling the world I'm making this. Everybody expects you to make this. Why change it too much? Unless you have to change for cinematic reasons. I agree with that. That's my view.
I was watching one of your videos. It was an inspirational talk that you were, making for some classes. So it was your trademark humor and you're communicating with the students directly and you're telling them that Sachin Tendulkar is aspirational and mujhko dekhkar aapko aisa lagega ki agar ye kar sakta hai to hum bhi kar sakte hain. So you like to have this self-deprecating humor about yourself, I think, which always has made you likable. Then you went into the serious zone that if you invest in yourself in 20s, so you can reap the benefits of that for the rest of your life. I've always felt that you want to have a certain connect with your with the youngsters. It seems as if you owe something to them. It seems that you want to show them a certain path without being preachy. Why is it important for you?
You know, Faridoon, first time I must have given hundreds of interviews. First time someone has asked this question. I'm really glad that you noticed this. Yeah, I feel your point is kind of true. I feel I owe something to my country. In my country, life is a struggle for everyone. And it's I've also struggled, but look at the rewards I've got. I mean, my country gave me an IIT, my country gave me an IIM, my country gave me a name as an author, name as in films, and even as a columnist or everything which I have wanted to do. My country has given me so much love. So what am I going to do? And the people who have given me most are my readers. And in a way, you can call it an extreme customer service, you know, because who are my customers? My readers. And my first job is to give them a good book so they enjoy the book while they are reading it in a flight or train or in their home. But what's the next level of caring for the customer? How can I enter their life and improve them? And it automatically came when I used to go for my book launches. In 2-3 questions, what they will ask, okay, this is the story, why Keshav did this, why Saurabh did this, why Prerna died, Karwa Chauth, okay. Fourth question would be, sir, how do I study for IIT? Fifth question would be, how do I get a good job? How do I write a book? How do I break into the film industry? how do I rise? Now I can say, it's not my job, guys. You read my book. Thank you for watching the movie. Okay, bye. And that's what most celebrities do. But I feel that I was there one day. I was like them. I had not cleared the IIT. I was a 10th pass. I had 76%. I was sitting in the audience and nobody was telling me how to go about it. So I feel if I do it, it's not just self-deprecation when I say, ki yaar Sachin to matlab God hai, lekin main to mere ko dekh ke to lagta hai ki is namune ka ho gaya to kisi ka bhi ho sakta hai. I want them to believe in themselves. I want them to believe ki I am like them. When I say that, I become like them. Because that's how they relate to it. Ki haan yaar, ye to humari tarah baat karta hai. Ye to hum jaisa tha. Aur ye sach mein stage pe pahunch gaya. So, you know, that self-confidence I need to give them. That is the motivation I can give. Motivation ke to aap 50 videos dekh sakte ho YouTube pe. But what is the difference I am creating is they feel I am like him. He's like any other Indian, you know. And I think somewhere down the line, I try to do that. And that has given me a very, very loyal set of following, a loyal reader base that has gone on for almost 2 decades now. And that still gets excited when my book is out. It is not just the book that is creating the excitement. It is all the goodwill that is happening. On my Instagram also, I post a lot of motivational videos now. So, you know, that ultimately pays off. If I go to Kota and give a talk to 5,000 students, they will be there for me when the book comes out. It's just an unsaid contract.
What is the importance of sense of humor and romance in your book?
I think everybody needs humor. India is too serious. People get too serious. Look at open the news at night. There is so many debates there. All nobody makes joke. Nobody makes a nice joke and say, "Arey sir, jara jaane do." You know, everybody's freaking angry, man. Why the hell on the internet, on Twitter, everybody's fucking so angry. Sorry, beep that if you want to. I don't care. But they are just angry, and people are upset. And I feel people need to laugh a little more. And I feel it really. If you make people laugh, you make them feel good. And if you make them feel good, everything is forgiven. Maine aapko hasa diya na, uske baad meri book mein technically koi gadbad bhi hai, language ki ya kuch aur bhi gadbad hai, sab maaf hai. Usne hasaya humko, bas theek hai. You know, dating mein bhi to yahi hota hai. Agar aap hasa doge, to theek hai fir. Fir sab maaf hai, you know. So in a way, when you make people laugh, you make them happy. It's a way of showing that you care for them. And I think I have the gift. I can write, even in my murder mystery, it's funny. Even if you see the trailer where the girl is dying, usme bhi laddu jalebi ho raha hai, and then they're like this couple, and then the girl is dead. In the murder mystery, there is comedy. So I think I will never be without comedy. Comedy is everywhere in life. And even in the most tragic summation. So meri, like normally you have these hardcore crime fiction and crime stories, they'll be like, inspector aega, kaha hai, chalo ungliyo ke nishan lete hain. मेरी बुक में इंस्पेक्टर घर आएगा तो पहले उसको समोसे देंगे तो वो समोसे खाने बैठ जाएगा और फिर उसके बाद बोलेगा अच्छा हाँ वो भूल ही जाएगा कि क्राइम भी था विच इज व्हाट हैपेंस इन इंडिया यू नो पुलिस आएगी तो पहले उनके लिए चाय बनेगी फिर समोसे आएंगे यूएस में तो एफबीआई आती है तो एफबीआई कभी एफबीआई को बोला है कि सर चाय लेके थोड़े जलेबियां मंगाए आपके लिए पर इंडिया में थोड़ा अलग चलता है सो आई फाइंड इट फनी आई फाइंड इट रिलेटेबल एंड आई थिंक दैट मेक्स अ बेटर स्टोरी
एंड व्हाट अबाउट रोमांस
Romance, of course, I think is something, maybe I become less romantic now. That's why I must have moved to murder mysteries. But I think romance is a very big part of why people live. I mean, that's my observation of people. As a writer, you observe everybody wants love. People want money also, and people want other things also. But that is still a little obvious, you know. People go to work every day. Ki haan, office ja rahe hain kyun paise kamane ke liye. But nobody expresses that I want love. Uske liye koi 9:30 baje office nahi pahunchta hai na. There's no office to get love. So it's a very big need in people I've seen. And I knew this once my books came out. I thought only youngsters will enjoy these love stories. But I had like 75-year-old uncles coming to me and saying, you know, the, your love story of half girlfriend reminded me of my girlfriend. Wo mujhe chhod ke chali gayi. He's 75 now. I'm like, okay. But, you know, I still think of her sometimes. So it's universal. It's what we live for. Everything cannot be about career and everything can't be about main zindagi mein aage kaise badhu aur motivate karo aur 20s mein kaam karo. Kis liye karna hai kaam? Kis liye success chahiye? Kis liye paise chahiye? You have, jab wo sab aa jayega aapke paas aur freedom aa jayega apni life jeene ka, to kya karoge? Aapki zindagi mein pyaar hi nahi hai, to fir bacha kya? So I think love makes the world go round. And it's always going to be part of my character's journey. एवरी लाइक इसमें भी अभी ये वाली में भी वन अरेंज मर्डर में भी जो मर्डर केस है वो उसकी मंगेतर का है जो अरेंज मैरिज हो रही थी बेचारे की.